The Apollo missions proved humans can work on the lunar surface, but the longest lunar spacewalk lasted a total of 22 hours. Could humans spend longer amounts of time on the moon? How about live there, as they do on the International Space Station? I'm Alana Bartolini from ESA Education, and here today with me is lunar technology expert Bérengère Houdou, who's going to join us to talk about life on the moon. Welcome, Bérengère.
Good morning. I'm very happy to spend a bit of time today with you talking about living on the moon. This may sound a crazy idea, but this could be possible sooner than we think.
So tell me, Bérengère, what are the main differences between living on the moon and on Earth?
There are many, but I will concentrate on three main ones I can think of. First of all, one of the most obvious differences between the Earth and the moon is the fact that the moon has no atmosphere. And no atmosphere means no blue sky, no air to breathe, no life, no weather. You cannot go simply outside on the moon. You need to wear a very well designed and pressurized spacesuit. It's a sort of mini spacecraft all around you. The second difference I would like to point out regards gravity. If you weigh 30 kilograms here on Earth, on the moon, you weigh only 5 kilograms. As experienced by the Apollo astronauts, walking around on the moon is not that easy and takes actually quite some time to get used to. They developed a sort of bunny hop in order to be able to move around, and this method basically helps them not to fall over when they were going forward. Harrison Smith, who is the last man that walked on the moon, said actually it was like walking on the giant trampoline. Quite fun, probably, actually. Since your muscles will not be as stimulated as on Earth, you will need to plan a very thorough and intensive exercise daily training in order to avoid to become a couch potato. The last difference I would like to tell a few words about is about the temperature range. Since the lunar surface is relatively dark, its reflectivity is about the same as the open ocean here on Earth. And since you have no weather, no clouds to cool the surface, during the day, the temperature on the moon can get to 120 degrees. It's extremely hot, of course, you can realize. And that's why the Apollo astronauts only went out on the surface outside of their module in the morning time in order to make sure the sun would still be low, we're talking about 15 degrees, so that they don't get too hot and their systems are operational in standard conditions. As dangerous, actually, is also the fall of temperatures during the night. And during that time, it can get until minus 135 degrees Celsius, so well below frozen temperature. And it's also important to be aware that on the moon, the nights last actually 14 Earth days, and the days the same. Last but not least, you would have an amazing view of the Earth from the lunar surface. The Earth is indeed 3.7 times larger than the moon, and it covers over 15 times as much of the skies as the moon does when you're looking at it from your bedroom.
So in the future, will humans be able to live on the moon for longer periods of time?
Very good question. After 50 years since the American with astronauts and the Russian with robots reached the lunar surface, the moon is finally again a destination of very high interest. This new discovery is opening new perspectives when thinking about living on the moon. Because in that case, if it's true, we will not need to bring with us everything from the Earth, and we will be able to live from the land, in a way. And actually, many people around the world are working on it. Engineers, scientists, doctors, politicians, and so on. Humans will not live on the moon for a very long time on the first go. I don't believe so. There will be a first build-up, progressively setting up on the surface. We stay starting with a few days, then evolving to a few weeks, and finally months, hopefully. This will allow the astronauts to get acquainted with the very extreme environment of the moon, as we already discussed before, and as well to set up progressively all the necessary supporting systems and infrastructure, a bit like basically we did when we were exploring and starting the exploration of Antarctica. Living on the moon for a long time will only be possible at very specific locations on the moon, which today are actually still unexplored. And I'm talking particularly over the South Pole region, which presents very specific characteristics of illumination. There, you can find places at quite some higher elevations where the sun shines over 90% of the year, which is of course very favorable from a solar energy point of view.
Now for a question I think many people would like to know. Could there be an actual moon village in the future?
A lunar village in the sense of a human community of a certain size, living and working on the moon in a sustainable manner, will ask for a completely new lunar way of life. It means developing and using innovative, smart, new space systems, developing new capabilities in the area of radiation protection, in the area of food, water, oxygen, carbon dioxide management and recycling, and all those topics being actually also a very high interest for here on Earth. People are already living in space. I'm sure you have already heard about the International Space Station around the Earth. And of course there are already a specific system helping with what we call life support to help the astronauts live and survive in space. For instance, one of them is about taking the carbon dioxide exhaled by the astronaut, concentrating it, and then breaking the molecules in order to recover the oxygen part. So such type of systems will be needed for a long stay on the moon, even more performance, and possibly combined with other recycling loops, like for instance to support the growing of plants for food production and so on. At the end, the moon is our closest neighbor, still about 400,000 kilometers away. And as such, there we can test new technologies, we can gain knowledge, we can set up new science infrastructure, and in that way, prepare our travel to even further destinations in the solar system.
Bérengère, did you ever dream of living in a moon village? And how did you come to work in lunar exploration?
Yes, I often dream about becoming a moonaut. But it will probably not be possible for me, maybe for you. And I actually started working in space already at the very beginning of my career. And I worked on systems to help astronauts, training them before they go to the International Space Station in terms of orientation, helping with designing spacesuits and so on. And then I evolved towards studying a mission, fully European, going to the moon, from launching from the Earth until operating different scientific payload on the surface. And that's where basically I caught the bug for lunar exploration. I enjoy very much working every day on developing new technologies for exploration and expanding our knowledge of the moon. And this actually with numerous men and women in Europe but also in the world, engineers, scientists, and so on. There are many different jobs to make living on the moon become true, and why not one for you?
Sounds like a very exciting career. Thank you very much for joining me today, Bérengère.
You're very welcome, my pleasure.
If you enjoyed this episode, stay tuned for our next one all about the future missions on the moon.